Well, great. Helps if I unmute my mic, don't it, guys? Start again. Good evening and welcome to Monday night's Hobby Hangout here at the Raven's Rook. My name's Phil and welcome again to our Monday night live stream Hobby Hangout. This week, guys, I am going to be painting for a change, and we're painting the Apothecary for my Raven Guard army. I've got it all built up the other night in a hobby hangout with Mr. Smith. We're just chatting away, building. I've got it all primed up and ready to go. So hopefully get quite a bit done tonight and chat away with you guys in the chat and hopefully get a bit of hobbying done. That's pretty much it for the intro. I hope you've had a nice weekend, and I hope you've had a nice start to the week. Monday again is out of the way, and there's one less day to the weekend. So, without further ado, I shall pop over to the top-down cam, and we shall pop some music on. Hopefully this is working a lot better this week. I've had a little fiddle with it, and yeah, it should, he says, work that little bit better. Hopefully one of you guys in the chat will let me know if it's popping over me or not, and if it's too low. We shall see. Hopefully that's leave it there. We'll see what you guys in the chat. So, as I was saying, I've got it all built up and ready to go. So, here he is. I've gone with the larger pistol, like the Absolver pistol that the Chaplain has, just for pure rule of cool. And went for the little needle at the top here instead of the bone saw, just in case if I get another one, I'll put the bone saw on the other one just so there's that difference between the two. So it's all built up, ready to go. I've just got him glued to a spur piece of sprue just for ease of paint while I'm on there. And we've got the base all, got the molded base on, ready to go. I'll just put some Strickland mud down the side of that to fill that in. It's already undercoated in black because obviously it's going to be a Raven Guard. And also, we've got the head just on a spare piece of wire just for ease of painting. And obviously once it's dried a little bit, we can get it glued in there tonight. Let's see how far we can get. Shall get started with this guy. Obviously undercoated it with Wraith Bomb, and we're going to go in with the Apothecary white contrast paint over the top. Just give this a good shake. Really need to get some ball bearings or something just to pop in these and just help agitate it that a little bit more. quite liberal with this. Anywhere there's white armor, where should we start? Get some of this color up here at first. Cards. I wanna make sound. Yeah, sorry, purely the cards, obviously, there's only a tiny bit at the top there. So obviously, although it says it's a white contrast paint, it is more of a grey. You just have to watch for it cooling, really. Contrast on, and probably just while that's drying off, just how I've got it set up, we'll be able to jump over to the base, get a bit of that done, or the helmet, and then vice versa, and just work our way around. And we got Mr. Hobby Corner Kev popping in all spicy. Good evening, pal. Thank you for dropping by just before we're streaming just over an hour, I believe. Yeah, play through tonight. I'm looking forward to that one. I'll try and jump on straight after the stream is finished here, and then try and catch up, play on double speed, catch up a bit. I hope you've had a nice day, pal. Well, yeah, because I remembered the contrast here because it's right in front of me this time. I can't go wrong too much. Doesn't matter too much about going over. Just getting the kids to sleep before I panic getting everything set up. That's where you need your dedicated hobby space, Kev. Instead of moving from corner to corner, or having to dismantle your corner, I should say. Just while you're in the chat as well, Kev, do the music sound okay to you? It's not overpowering me at all, or overriding. I've had a little play with it, so hopefully it's a little bit better this week. For some reason the app itself had reset the volume. I have no idea why I managed to go in and have a fiddle with that. Thank you. business model. Try and not let it keep shouting. Well, apparently I'm quite loud anyway. So I don't know if that's just would be Northern Cab. Unless it's gone off completely, because it's not registering now for some reason, but it still comes through my headset. That's where obviously you guys come in. So if everything's all hunky dory. At the same time. I put a video up of that, Kev. Kev doing his Kev dance. Or is that for the OnlyFans? Yeah, I get what you meant there. So with the music this week, we've just gone that little bit emo. Obviously, we're going back to my Raven Guard. Obviously, painted the emo chapter. We need the emo music. It's looking quite grey at the moment, but see how that goes on. It actually doesn't look too bad. Obviously, I'll see how it dries. With my contrast paint, I use my Snakebite Leather, hint in the name, for all my leather areas, my pouches and stuff, and then also for some of the robes on some of them, I've used it for that, and then the rest has been the contrast black for the armour. So being an apothecary, you can't have a black armoured Apocryphress. Oh. Give this a whirl. See, it just, I don't know if it'll show up on this camera now, it's not the greatest camera. It just shades it that little bit and just sits in the recess. Like, it's supposed to give you like a little cheat towards, so you don't have to edge highlight everything. It's supposed to do it for you. Just rather than putting the normal pauldron on this guy as well, with him being from the Raven Guard, I thought, where I've got a few spare shoulder pads left, I give him the Raven Guard one, but it's got the splash guard on the side. Just thinking of this, like, Apocryphray, he's on battlefield and he's collecting all the gene seed from the fallen ones, and obviously it's going to stop it being splashed in the face. Quite happy with that so far. The idea is I might come in with a dry brush of White Scar. It's a layer paint, just dry brush, just to bring out some more of those highlights out, or the, like the smooth areas like on his knee pad and stuff like that. So once that bit's drying off, shall get the old Strickland mud out and we'll get the mud on the base so it's drying and ready. Find the spreading tool, always prepared. Some dry brush. Put stuff down and it just disappears. There it is. Falling out of paintbrush pot, which is an old Nescafe cup. That's a good old shake up. Virtually empty this tub now. And luckily, I've managed, with the shops being back open, I've managed to go and pick up. Actually, no, what are you doing? It's my Raven Guard. has his Martian base. I nearly messed up straight from the start there. Our way around. Lower painting over there, this will dry nicely, and when we come back to this we can start on the dead body and get the rocks painted up as well, just so they tie in. With it being rubble, we've got obviously they're going to be grey rather than the red, so it should give it a nice contrast between the two. Well, that's me thinking behind it anyway. Just scuff this bit up a bit, just to add a bit of extra texture. So I'll just pop that to one side, let that dry off a bit. Quite happy with how that's dry. It's pooled in little areas, but as it's certain areas it looks like natural shades with it. Actually just want to try and get a little bit more, just to get them up in this vent up here. But yeah, as a first go using this contrast paint, I'm quite happy with how that's turned out. And we've got Mr. Andy Allen, popping in the chat. Hello, Quingo. Yes, my G. I hope you're well, pal. Hope you've had a good day. Hope you're not wasting more time looking at more cars. Hopefully you'll find one that you like seeing. Start travelling about and meet up with some people and, you know, get a few games in and stuff. I went with the white contrast. I already had some anyway. Obviously just after a little chat on your stream the other day. I spoke to a few people and said, obviously it's an Epoch 3, you can do what you want. If he's going in with your Raven Guard army just painting black, is, you know, it would be black to help hide. But I went for more like a grimy without doing the old streak and grime. Sorry, that was poor. So, yeah, we'll see how we get on. So, the contrast's done now. I'm just going to do a light dry brush just to bring it back up on these knee pads and just the odd extreme edge. See how that comes up. The robe, we're going to go red as normal. Obviously, I've got to get some black around the Raven Guard bit there. So, yeah, up to now, pretty happy with how it's turning out. So, let's just switch it over and get the old trusty dry brush out. Come in with a white scar. Let's give this a good shake. I've got some more contrasts to play with and try as well. I've got a nice red contrast to try for, obviously once I've painted red, it's more of a shade. It'll call over. Is it the Caraberg Crimson? Just to help it darken it down in the recesses. Let's see. That's a bit more off. To the collection of dead Raven Guard when I find them with my face. We shall see. Extreme edge back on. Yeah, that's like that actually. That's looking nice. Missing a few of this just so it looks like a little bit more grotty and grimy. Oh, awesome. Yeah, looking forward to getting you on as a guest, dude. Talk Raven Guard. Yeah, I've got to do a bit more of the old research just yet. But yeah, I got your message today. Apparently my phone had an update, and a lot of my stuff for my Discord, I've been posting stuff on Discord and stuff like that, but a lot of the messages weren't showing up for some reason. I have no idea why, but apparently it's all working out. I did get your message today, but I was halfway through the golf course at the time, so I couldn't really message you back. But yeah, but definitely come on and show you roughly where I'm at, what I'm still working on, what's still partially done and stuff like that. It'll be a good laugh. This is where it all goes terribly wrong. I'm coming with the black. I'll try and get around this bird. I do go really, really quiet here, guys. It's only because extreme concentration is going on. And more than likely, my tongue will be sticking out. I want to spot lions. It's definitely going to take more than one coat with a black just to get the nice flat. So it's going quite lumpy, that, for some reason. Let's thin it down a little bit. I'll try and get it on, and obviously. Black's going to, it's the black's the complete opposite to white, so it's going to contrast against that quite nice. Probably give golf a go at some point. Yeah, I mean, I hadn't played golf since I was a kid. Brother-in-law's recently got given some golf clubs. Obviously wanted me to go along with him. Didn't have to ask me twice, really. He's been to driving range a few times. Swacking it and stuff like that. Just want it to get out on a course and, you know, see how bad we were. It wasn't the best. Like, normally it'd say on the course that it's a par three, and like, we're hitting it in five or six. But no, it was more about just, you know, getting out, just me and brother-in-law and having a laugh. So, you know, end of the day, that's all I wanted, and that's what we got out of it. Did manage to chip a shot in from about 70 yards out as well. Chipped it up, you lovely little shot it was. Yeah, straight on the green and roll straight in the hole. I think that hole 10 we was on. I think people who were teeing off on hole 1 could have heard me screaming. It was just one of them moments that, you know, you probably get a few in a lifetime where you'd hit a shot like that. No, I did a really good day. So. Come in again. Just touch up the Raven on the pauldron, and we'll come over with some contrast again after. So I've just caught one of the legs on the bird, but it's not a great loss because obviously I don't want to just leave the bird all Wraith born. We'll come back to that. Yeah, it's definitely going to need another court, but there's the general idea. Obviously he's got his black pauldron there. Today it's just that hot and close, so it is yeah, happy with that. Obviously touch it up a little bit. Yep, that's the black dog. While that's drying now, I've come in and all the creases in the armour. I've got the rubber bits here. You can see one on the arm here and just a little bit up in there and there. I'm going to use the same colour that I use for the gun, so we'll get the gun done at the same time there. I'll put it there. Shoot, dude, we'll be catch up later. No problem at all. Thank you for popping in, Andy. I shall catch you later on, dude. Hope you have a nice evening. Thanks again for dropping by. Same colour I've used on all my other Raven Guard. For the joints, just because obviously I don't want obviously with them having black armour, just so there's that little bit of a break between the armour. I just come in with this like bluey grey. us that that little bit of a change, but not overly drastic. It doesn't stand out way too much. A little awkward sound just in here, just because of how I've got it on this bloody sprue to pair. It's just giving it an awkward angle to try and get in this way. Music's definitely a little bit darker this week. Bit of a scream fest for now. Good evening, Mr. Smith. Your ears must have been burning. Obviously, just in the intro, was saying how we got this guy built up last night while we was hanging out in a hobby hangout, just chilling away. Myself, me and Kev, late last night, just chatting away. YouTube won't let me join because of all the epicness going on here. I doubt that. You don't watch epicness happening here, pal. But no, thank you very much for tuning in, as always, pal. It's very much greatly appreciated. Pretty much the gaps in the armour done now, so we should just work our way around the gun. Mr. Gary Knox popping in as well. Good evening. Thank you for tuning in. Looking awesome, mate. Cracking model. Busy sorting kids out for bed. Wanted to smash a like. Say keep up the great work. Thank you very much, pal. It's greatly appreciated. Every single one of you pops in, and you know, just even if you're not subscribed, just you know, a like or just a hi. It's very much greatly appreciated. I hope you're well, pal. Which I don't know if it will show up on here. No, it's already drilled. It's pre-drilled, but it wasn't pre-drilled. I drilled it last night during the build. Um, Yeah. So now all my barrels are drilled. I'm happy to say here on the Raven's Rook, there is no drill gate. All barrels are drilled. It did take me a while to catch up with, you know, through 2,000 points worth of Raven Guard. But all my barrels are drilled. And surprisingly, I managed to get them all nice and straight. Trying to not get the medics and bullets. Oh my god, that's obviously where it is. Wraithborn at the moment. Actually, the medic symbols are painted in red and it'll stand out a lot more with a undercoat that's lighter. Sorry if I keep going quiet, guys. It's really concentrating on these awkward bits. So when it gets close to the armor, I don't want to be getting any dark colours onto the contrast paint. And it's not completely the end of the world. I can, you know, go back in with the white and do a wash over it again, but if I don't have to, I don't, you know, want to be making extra work for myself. The black stride really nice on the pauldron as well, which is a nice little contrast from that. So I'm just coming with some of the metal bits now. We'll get some of them touched up just while I'm on that area. Just want to get that part of the bun finished off and see how we're getting on. Starting to run a little bit low, right? Just coming with our lead belt here. Follow the, when you've got the casing at the top, we just want to follow that round. With that, getting a nice drilled barrel. I hope you guys in the chat managed to get some hobbying done today, or getting some done this evening. And yeah, just give us a shout in the chat, let us know what you're working on. Sure, whatever it is, it'll be absolutely awesome. Seeing the work you guys put in the socials. Side of the group, which I forgot. That's the piece already. Do it off camera then. A little bit up in here. the side. If we start getting some more colour on, it should start tying it all together that little bit more. That one we're going to do in a like a brassy colour. This one. Go for the normal metal. Sometimes just that little bit of colour like this, even though it is like a silver, it helps, you know, tie it all in that little bit. Obviously, let's get some washes on, that'll help even more. Dirty it up that little bit. Very nicely, thank you very much, Mr. Kev. Yeah, it's like I say, like you get a wash on anything that's not working that well, and then you know, just the little splash of colour here or there, and it makes quite a lot of a difference. It's surprising sometimes. You stick with it, you know, if you've got that idea in your head. Yeah, just stick with it and see it through to the end. If it works, it works. If it doesn't, just try again, yeah. Little vials on the back. Hurt us, we'll leave them. Cable down there. This casing and the drill, we're going to drill bit itself, that'll be a different colour. Just for it to stand out a little bit. good spots just on this. This week I just wanted to get back to painting some more towards my Raven Guard, obviously with stores opening back up now, and hopefully in the next couple of months, in the next couple of weeks we'll be available to start having some games. So I just wanted to get my force ready. This is one of the models I was missing, and my war suit. So I managed to get these built up, get this painted now, and then over the next week or two, try and get my tactical war suit done. It's a bit of a bigger model, so obviously it'll take that little bit more to paint that bad guy up, especially how I've got it all posed, more like a mini diorama or a vignette, I think it's the right word. Looking forward to getting that one done as well. I just wanted to get this one, not so much out of the way, but get this one done, with it being the smaller one. And then hopefully it should all be good to go, ready when we can play some games. I'm sure you guys would have heard me saying I'm in the one of the Warhammer shops near me. I won the store anniversary, one of the prizes, 2 years ago. It's basically a gaming day in store, so yeah, I wanted to get everything done and ready for that, and you know, get some Raven Guard out on the table, get me first game in, you know, win or lose, it doesn't matter. At the end of the day, it's playing the game. I'll see you later, mate. Thank you very much for tuning in, Kev. I know you've got a stream going any minute now. Your playthrough for Immortal Realms, so good luck. I don't know if you're playing against the missus again or not tonight, you're not sad. If you are, take it easier on her this week. But thanks for popping in, dude. I'll jump on and catch up and say hi once I finish here. I shall see you soon. Exhausts on the top here. Back over that with a white, probably off stream, and then just touch it up. Ready. So that'll have some colour in. It's sucking all the stuff out of the Space Marines. To this gene seed. Start getting some colour on this, mate. Really. That's what I drink. See how this works out. I'm coming now. Some corn red. So I just want to try and miss all these robes here. Quite a bush isn't going to work, I think. This one's definitely going to work out. It's a bit of a darker red. Raven Guard, yeah, I don't want it too, you know, your medic running around with a definitely going to get seen a bit more. I'll come back and I'll fix that later. Going an hour already. Damn. Time definitely flies. Just try and follow this line. Rob all the way up. We've got Pickle Queen popping in. Good evening, Wendy. I hope you're well. Definitely a quieter one tonight. Just working away on my Pocket 3. Bit more chill than usual. Probably go off a bit more now because you're in the chat. Well, thank you for tuning in. I hope you're well. Hope you've had a nice weekend. No, it's fine. You don't have to apologise for, you know, people come and go. You know, pop in and out of the chat all the time, so I don't ever feel like you need to apologise. Music is a little loud or you are quiet. Could have gone quieter. Try and turn it. That should be a bit better, or it might have gone off now. I was having a fiddle with it earlier. Some of the guys were saying it were okay, but I don't know if it's, you know, at the end of the day it's personal preference. Some people like them just about hear the music, or, you know, some like to have it on a little bit louder. That's better, no problem. Red's a lot darker than I was anticipating. hopefully it'll help me in the long run when it comes up to edge highlighting. Also shading in the recess. We shall see how that dries. Probably Kev's fault. It was Kev that said that the music was okay. It's so funny that you should say that. No, at the start of the stream, they were just me and Kev in the chat, so we were just chatting away. And I was having a fiddle with the volumes live just to try and get it right. But Kev being very, very sus again. Sabotage. But I do know sometimes, obviously, if you're watching on a PC or on a mobile phone, sometimes it can be quite different, the volumes. And then obviously, like I've noticed, on if you're watching some people on a mobile phone, it'll only come through one of the earpieces. Yeah, still a learning curve, still, you know, not up to Pickle standard. But we're getting there week by week. And different songs will be at different volumes. That actually, thinking about it, because I only really had trouble once I switched over onto this playlist, which is supposed to be an emo. It says on the playlist, so it could be, you know, obviously where it's a bit more rocky, there's more bass in the background, that could definitely thinking about it, that could have something to do with playing with the treble and the bass on it. Bass down for the red on the ball. Just get some of my coffee. Won't be a second, guys. Got you on while I wash up and prep breakfast for the morning. What are you painting? It is a apothecary, basically a medic for my Space Marines, for my Raven Guard. Normally they are white. I have seen people paint them in the chapter colours, but I just wanted mine to stand out a little bit and stay true to the law. So he is white, just with a contrast paint, which just grimes it down that little bit. He's got his red robe, and yeah, he's got his little Raven Guard pauldron on. We're just working our way through this guy tonight. Let's see how far we can get. We got probably got about another half hour, 45 minutes, before I've got to, you know, got to start getting some stuff ready myself for work tomorrow. But yeah, we'll see how far we can get on with this guy. It'll be hopefully nice to see you getting some more painting done again soon as well, Wendy. I know you was having a lot of fun doing your battle cat. Nice to see what you come up with next. It's the little medic symbol on. Promising myself how to paint it. Life just gets in the way though, doesn't it? I mean, I'm quite lucky that I can get on most nights, get a bit of painting done. It just helps me with my stress. Helps keep my PTSD in check, you know, just chill out for a few hours most nights. Even a lot of the time we get into on a Discord chat and end up doing more talking than painting. But yeah, I think it's more like the social aspect of it. Quite busy week this week. I've only got 3 days in work this week actually, so I'm not too bad. Managed to get Friday booked off purely because I'll be sat up late on Thursday night, ready for the NFL for the draft for the American football. A few of us from work managed to get the day off, so I would sit there and have a chat in over on the socials, watching the draft, just mocking each other, having a dig at who's picked who. So, unfortunately for us Brits, it doesn't start till 1 o'clock in the morning over here. Luckily I managed to get the day off work, so I can sit up, watch that and then get some sleep and not have to worry about getting up for work the next day. Walking with loud music in my ears, my anxiety. I think I need to concentrate to do my painting. I do that all day at work and just want to rest my time. A tiny break when you get in. Yeah, music's one of the ways I found as well. Depending on obviously the mood, depends on what kind of music you want to listen to as well. I mean, I'm quite varied in my music that I listen to anyway. I mean, I can listen to heavy metal, rock, but then I could be listening to something a bit more poppy or classical even. So depending on, obviously, my mood, depends on what music I want to listen to. But yeah, the music's a very good one for, especially with like anxiety, like you said yourself. But you know, whatever works for you, what works for one person might not work necessarily for another one. It's just looking sick, that Red and Black was popped. We have a very electric bass. Yeah, Mr. Smith, obviously the black shoulder pad. I'm just trying to get some edge highlighting in the next red up on this one, just before I put a wash on, just to help tie it in. But yeah, really happy with how this is coming along and turning out now. Definitely been listening to more weird music lately. I found a new guilty pleasure music wise, which was a group called Two Cellos. And basically they're on two cellos, but they're playing all kinds of different music, but they can be playing old rock and stuff, so a bit like AC/DC and that sort of music, but on cellos. It sounds like it wouldn't work, but it is actually really, really good. It's definitely a guilty pleasure at the moment. And I can't even remember what he's called, man. It's more electric music, but he's done some work with a famous conductor. Some of the stuff they've done is really, really good. Happy how that red contrasts against the next one. That's really nice. I'm quite pleased with how that's popping now. Nothing wrong with a bit of cello. Honestly, Mr. Swift, I don't know if you've heard of them or not. Definitely go check them out. They are really, really good. One of them's a famous, obviously, celloist, but he does the violin as well. But it is really good. It did shock me a bit how much I was enjoying them. They were really good. A bit like is it Apocalypta, where they were doing all the Metallica sort of stuff. Very similar to that, but not as full on rock, like with the long hair and head bopping. So it takes you back. It looks like a normal cello concert, and then they start blasting all kinds of stuff out. nice some of this contrast. I've not used this one before, so we'll see how this goes. Apparently this works really well, especially if you're doing like Space Marine's eyes. You get your red down, if you're doing red eyes that is, and then just a drop of this wash in just helps highlight it that little bit, drops a little bit of a darker, kind of like adds an eye line sort of an effect in, basically. Need be afterwards, we can always come back in and just touch up the edge highlight on this. Definitely be coming in and just touching these robes up just before I turn them brown to the leather. With that paint, it's spit my words out. I let that dry. It's a bit like there's little grains. Just while I've got my red out, I'll just get my broken tools out. It's the only one that I've got that's got the finest tip. So I've got my Mark III, and it's the 3.0. I just want to get the eye done on this helmet, just while I've got this red paint out. Now, it's the first time I'm using one of the smallest of the broken jaw. Bit of a test moment. With flying bloody colours. Honestly guys, if you've not got some broken toed brushes, go and get some. I mean, these things are just awesome. I mean, that's the, I've got him first time. I mean, I'm not the greatest painter, average at best, but you know, even with my shaky hands, you can get in and get an eye done like that. It's, well, here's another test. He says, we'll try and get the apocryphal symbol on here. test number two for the old broken dudes. Shake your hands. Seem to obviously don't want a lot of paint on the brush, but because it's the finest of details, but that's the best symbol I painted on there. Obviously it's really, really tiny, so it's quite fiddly, but I mean, first attempt, I mean, the eye come out perfect. I'm absolutely buzzing with that. That is just perfect. Just a drop of a wash in that, so if I can get that. It's a small brush, but taking it off in the middle. I'm definitely going to have to get a close-up picture of that for social. I'm absolutely buzzing with how good that couldn't have gone any better than if I planned it. Apart from it falling over. Stay. So yeah guys, if you've not got some, get some broken tool brushes. I mean, if they can make, you know, an amateur like me paint half decent, you know, imagine what it can do for some of you guys. So what I'm gonna do, it's the same brush again, the old 3.0. I'm just going to come in. I'm just going to get these straps on here. Just with some white scar, just to get a bit of a pale. I'll get some white back down, I should say. So obviously these straps here are going to be leather. So how I do my leather, I use my another contrast paint. So I'll be coming back in with my Snakebite leather. So I just want it clear and colour. Back way nice and slow. Feel the ebb and flow. Please get sucked out to sea. I wonder where you are. Cause you know I take these things kinda extra hard. This back and forth. Some bits where we've overrun with the red though. Yeah, I'm absolutely buzzing with how this is coming along now. Let's carry on with home and paintings. Obviously getting better from my first couple of models. I'm definitely going to have to go back and either retouch some up or extend them a bit more just so they're matching. However, some of my Marines that I have got are firstborn. So obviously the old size. But I mean, they will tie in with my force because you're not going to have just... you can have just Primaris. But if Primaris are supposed to be a reinforcement to your... chapter, unless your chapter was completely wiped out, you're definitely gonna have some firstborns, even if they are just, you know, like painted up as veterans. Broken top back away because I'll jump onto some metallics and I am definitely not using these brushes for metallics. Protector back on. So, got a gold leaf on. The urns in here and here. So we'll get them done and then we'll see where we're at. I've returned. What did I miss? Oh, you missed absolutely everything. It was rammed, Pickle Queen. I mean, there were hundreds in here. As if. No, you didn't miss much. Obviously, I've shaded up on the robe. I don't know if you saw that. Touched up, ready for getting the leather on there. And I managed... I mean, it's the best job I've ever done on a Space Marine's helmet. I managed to get the eye perfect with my broken toe brush. I mean, being a white helmet, I was really scared of doing the red in. Let's see if I can get it. I'm gonna focus. It's really cheap camera, it's not gonna focus. You can just make out the red blur. Which is the eye and then the apocryphal symbol on his helmet. And yeah, I got it absolutely first time, which was an absolute shocker for me. Just singing the praises of the Broken Toads. I mean, you know, like I was saying, if someone like myself, an amateur painter at best, can achieve some of the, you know, the painting skills, I should say, or finishes that I've managed, I mean, in the hands of someone who's half decent or really good, I mean, a bit, it's just ridiculous what you can achieve with them. Quiet, I'm really sorry, I'm just trying to concentrate because I don't want to, especially with metallics, I don't want to be. Overflowing on. Yeah, armour, especially white armour. Just because obviously with metallics it's harder to cover back up. You'll have two viewers, other days 22. It's the nature of live stream. Yeah, I mean, I've been quite lucky. I've had a steady flow of views, which, you know, I'm really, really grateful for. I'm grateful for everyone that, you know, tunes in and stops by. Especially because with it being a Monday, it's a fickle time, isn't it? A lot of people, you know, it's that first day back in work, you just want to get home, chill out, stick a bit of telly on, and then go to bed. You know, not a lot of people want to sit there and watch a YouTube channel or something like that on a Monday night, and, you know, each to their own. It's definitely swings and roundabouts. You know, it depends on the content as well. You know, if people want to watch an apothecary, they might not. They might want to watch, you know, some Mortal Realms stuff or a certain chapter. So they're all going to look for certain stuff anyway, and I totally understand and respect that, you know. End of the day, it's down to them. I mean, when it's harder, when you've got less viewers, especially like for a smaller channel like myself, you know, you've only got one or two people in it, is harder in the chat. You know, don't get me wrong, I'm under no disillusion, but to then one day, you know, if I do manage to, you know, make it that little bit bigger, and you've got more people in the chat, then I think you appreciate it more, because obviously you're always going to remember what it was like in the beginning when, you know, you've only got a few followers and stuff like that. So obviously, I mean, you appreciate every single one of your followers anyway, but I mean, you appreciate them even more. They've become like family in a way, you know what I mean? That, you know, I'm waffling on now, but to appreciate the good times, you've got to have the bad times, basically. It's the same as anything in life, so that's what I was trying to get at. And that gold's really helped pop that out as well, though. I really, really happy with this. So I think we'll get the leather done. Yeah, we'll get the leather done next, and then that is, I think, going to be pretty much it. I mean, it's 25 past nearly now. We'll get the leather done, so we've got the pouch. And gun case, and fat one. I've got the gold out, just want to get the emblem on the top of this shoulder pad here. I'll have it on in the background depending on what I'm doing. I try and tune in as many times. I can't, even if it's just half an hour. I think he's VM calling you. Me bad times.
No, I'm not saying it's bad times, because obviously I've only got you two guys in the chat talking. I'm trying to say, obviously, when you've got lesser viewers, when you've got the more, you appreciate it more. That you've gone through having hardly, you know, oh, you got me now, Mr. Smith. Git. Yeah, you will bloody laugh. I'm really, really happy. Honestly, I didn't think that this contrast paint was going to work as a white, but I mean, I don't know if it's showing up. I mean, if I hold it down against the red and then obviously the black, it is like a really dirty white. It does play a good trick on the eye. Yeah. I get you, brother. You get me wound up. I'll get this contrast paint out. We'll get this done, and then we'll see what we're doing. So there's a little pouch just in here. Hoping as well this brown's going to help pop it out. I was going to do the robe in a brown. Is it my one of my chaplains is in? He's got a brown cloak, and also on the Judica, whoever owns pronouncing it, and everyone pronounces it different. On them, he's got a brown cloak as well. But when I've been looking, and obviously like a little bit of research on the apothecaries, they all had the red cloak for the medic. So I've tried staying as true to the lore as possible. But you know, you can mix it up, and at the end of the day, it's your model, you paint it how you want. I've always said that. But Yeah. You know. So the little symbol just etched in on the pad there, on the holster. So I can always come back to another pass with the leather, maybe just to darken it down that little bit, or what I found works quite well with it is just a very, like a watered down null oil, and just let it soak in, especially any like little recessed areas, that seems to work quite well. See how it dries off. So they still stand out against, obviously, a red. Sometimes like brown can be quite funny against red. I think it's only about five or six songs on this playlist, but I've quite enjoyed this one. It's been a bit of a change. It says emo, but it's not. So much like emo music. Cheers, Rich. Yeah, it's always a funny one with the music, because obviously you want to play some music that you like, but then also you want to put some music on that people who are watching is going to like as well. So it's finding that happy little medium, isn't it? So yeah, the leather's standing out really nice against that red and the white. I'm proper happy with that. He's got a little like knife and a little dagger just in his cloak here. Just while I've got the gold, my gold paint to hand, I just want to get them done. Before it dries. I always end up noticing something and constantly going backwards and forwards, backwards and forwards. Can't wait to see the Pikmin Discord. Cheers, Rich. Yeah, definitely. I'll get a progress so far in the whip gallery in the Discord. Sorry, getting mixed, muddled with words again. Just how I've got on tonight, and then I'll more than likely end up finishing it tomorrow after working one at Hangouts. If we're doing a hangout tomorrow night on the Discord, just so it's ready from the on Pickle Vision on Wednesday under the old Loki approved section of the Pickle Jar. Always try and get at least one thing a week done just to show on. On the pickle jar. The best show by far that, you know, I've ever watched or had the privilege of watching. Especially within our hobby. Not doing a discredit to Josh, there's people out there that have got, you know, are bigger in the community. Not mentioning names, but I mean Josh is getting there now, but he's still stayed true to his channel and how he is, which, you know, it's a testament to himself, and I've said it all along, it feels more like a group of mates hanging out and hobbying. And, you know, that's how it should be. Speaking of which, Wendy's just been doing pickles here in the pack, haven't we? Has it all been, have you straightened it off, or was it, you know, more like combing it through and then him flicking it about pretending to be in a Timotei advert under a waterfall? I think that's more like a Mr. Dodge video, that, isn't it? On the pickle only fans. Giving her a good wash, conditioned it, blow dried and brushed it. He's not a bloody dog, Wendy. Jesus Christ. Oh, you know what? I want to get this helmet finished before I go off. I'm going to get at least the helmet done. So, I was thinking it's green. Clipped his claws. Oh, reverb mode engaged. Hey. I missed something, Rich. I don't get what you're getting at. Sorry, pal. You say something stupid when I'm heard and he's to look after it. See, I've quite done the similar, obviously, because we were in lockdown, where I struggle with alopecia, my hair got longer, and it, you know, it helped cover my alopecia. So I've kind of like kept it long on the top, but then mic went weird again. I don't know why it keeps doing that. Sometimes I've watched it back when you were saying last week when it went really echoey all of a sudden. It did it and then went off, but obviously I'm not touching those settings or nothing. But it definitely does happen because I've heard it back myself. So I've left my hair longer on the top. And then just shave the sides when we could go to the hairdressers. It's nowhere near as long as pickles, but it can be a pain in the backside to try and keep. Just doing now, got the lenses round the head, so he's got lenses there, and then like a spotlight sort of thing, but gone for a blue around there. Green in that. And next one. I'm gonna have to go like a yellow, I think. Just try and keep them all different. Aioli yellow. I have got. It's a Tesseract glow. It might. It should work because it is quite bright. Yeah, it sounds like you're in the bathroom. Your mic's gone weird again. Yeah, it's done it again. I think he's painting off the blue. Oh, it's probably because I've gone over 2 hours. That's why. It's you know, telling me, right, come on, you've got to get off. You've done your allotted 2 hours. Oh yeah, like that. Yeah, that works. So we've got that. And what we're going to do, I mean, because these contrasts do dry quite quick. I've only put light. Might bit over. Where's my gold gone? Just a touch of this gold. Just over the where the light is, there's like a cross section. Sorry guys, just using the edge of the table as a... Oh yeah, yeah, that's fucking staying as that, that is awesome. Great, let's see where we're at, I might be able... Talking myself into going that, just that, look at that. Oh, I'll just get that bit done. I'll just get that bit done. Get the back of this done, because then if I'm going to stick the helmet on in a second. Just so that you can see it before I go off. Sorry guys, I do keep going quiet, it's just... It's this stage I always get really, really paranoid. It starts coming together and you think, oh, it's looking so good, and then... It's one little foul swoop with it, or one daft stroke, you try and push it that little bit too far with the paint, and it goes off onto a different area that you don't want any paint on. And I don't want to spoil what I've managed to get done so far. I stick the helmet in or not? I mean, I can get to the... Yeah, sorry. We're going to put his helmet in and then we'll just line him up on his base. Just so we can see how it's coming together all in one piece. Just noticed a piece of mist. Sorry. Done it again. It's just a little piece on the back, and obviously once the helmet goes in, I won't be able to get to that. So with this, with the helmet, head it off. I'll catch you the other side. Enjoy the rest of the stream. Thank you very much, Wendy. I'll be wrapping it up in a minute anyway. So I just want to get the helmet stuck onto this guy. But thank you very much for dropping by and keeping myself and Rich, entertained and keeping the conversation going. Thank you very much. And I hope you have a nice rest of the week. And I shall speak to you soon. Let's break this off. I just super glued it on, so there we go. I'll just get my knife out, just clean this back. Some faults as well, okay. I definitely will just finish this bit on, and it shall be going up in Discord on the socials. Get it on the Chilling War Gamer one and on the Pickle Discord. Melted it like mad with it being super glue. I think I might put just a tad too much on. Some snips. So what I'm gonna do, snip that back completely. Dab on the bottom. Get that in there. That is looking absolutely sick. I know it's not going to show up as well on here, but I mean, the helmet, how I've managed to get that helmet looking like that, that's hands down the best one I've done yet. And definitely, I'll get some pictures up on the social so you guys can check it out later. So yeah, I think we're just gonna wrap things up there. Nearly 10 o'clock now, anyway, just gone over nearly 2.5 hours. Just flick it over to here. So yeah, we've got quite a bit done on that guy tonight. A lot more than I was expecting to get done tonight. And first time using the white contrast, I think it worked really well from how it's come out. And yeah, get it finished off this week and shall move on and hopefully start getting some more of my Raven Guard done, ready for the snow battle. So thanks again for tuning in, guys. I hope you've had a good time. I hope you've managed to get some hobby done yourselves, and I shall see you all next Monday. And yeah, we'll be doing some more painting. I'm enjoying more of the painting. I know we've been doing quite a lot of builds lately, but I want to try and get more painting done on the channel itself, so we'll get some of that done. Now waffling on though. But no, thank you again for tuning in. If you've not subscribed and you're watching this back later, please consider subscribing. I'm nearly at that 50 mark. I've only got 7 to go to hit that 50. It's a big milestone for myself. Yeah, like and subscribe and all the usual. And I shall catch you guys later. Thank you very much and goodbye.